Hi everyone, welcome back to SG Doctor Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. In the third episode of this STD series, I'll be sharing more about syphilis. Have you heard about syphilis? What are the symptoms and why is it called the Great Pretender? What is its association with HIV? If you're new to our channel, click on the subscribe button now. Syphilis is a sexually transmitted infection that can cause serious health problems if left untreated. It is caused by this spiral-looking bacteria called traponema pallidum. In Singapore, we are seeing an average of about 1,500 cases of newly diagnosed syphilis yearly for the past 5 years. In Europe and America, there has been an increase in the number of syphilis cases, going up by as much as 70% over the past 10 years. Syphilis is spread from person to person through sexual contact with the infected ulcers called chancres. Chancres can occur in, on, or around the penis, vagina, anus, rectum, and lips or mouth. They can spread during vagina, anal, or oral sex. Pregnant ladies with syphilis can also transmit the infection to their unborn child. You cannot get syphilis through casual contact with objects such as toilet seats, doorknobs, swimming pools, hot tubs, and bathtubs. You cannot get it through sharing of clothes or utensils as well. You can start to show symptoms of syphilis 10 days to 3 months from the exposure. Syphilis is referred to as the Great Pretender as its symptoms are varied and can mimic many other diseases. The infection can be divided into a few stages: primary, secondary, latent, and tertiary syphilis. The primary stage is the first stage of infection. In this stage, a skin papule or skin bump will first appear and subsequently develop into an ulcer or multiple ulcers that are often painless, firm, and round. This happens usually at the location where the syphilis enters the body, such as in the private areas like the vagina or the penis. This chancres usually last 3 to 6 weeks and disappear on its own whether or not you received the treatment. And if left untreated, the disease progressed to the secondary stage within 1 to 2 months. In the secondary stage, there are a few prominent signs that may occur. Firstly, would be skin changes like a rash, hair loss, or skin growths called condyloma lata. Secondly, patients may also develop flu-like reactions. So let's talk more about the skin changes. The rash. This typical rash usually appears as rough red or reddish brown spots or patches on the body, palms and soles, and they usually do not itch. However, the rash may appear in various forms as well that may be misdiagnosed as other conditions. Secondly, condyloma lata are these skin growths that can be skin colored or grayish white, and they are typically raised and occur in moist areas like the groin, the private area, and the perianal area, even sometimes armpit and the mouth. They tend to occur near to where the initial chancre was seen, and they can be mistaken as warts in some cases. Hair loss is another common skin change. Loss of hair, known as alopecia, may occur on the scalp, the eyebrow, or in the beard area in patches or widespread. The flu-like symptoms that may occur include fever, headache, and body aches, lethargy and fatigue, sore throat, swollen lymph nodes, loss of appetite, and even sometimes weight loss. So as you can see, in secondary syphilis, the skin rash may look like other skin conditions. Condyloma lata can be mistaken as viral wart, and flu-like symptoms can present like any other flu conditions, even COVID-19. Therefore, its famous alias, the Great Pretender. We must always have a high index of suspicion to diagnose syphilis. Secondary syphilis will then progress to latent syphilis if no treatment is given. This stage is the hidden stage where there are no symptoms and signs and it can last for years. However, individuals in the latent stage may still be infectious and may spread the bacteria to their sexual partners. Finally, about a third of patients with latent syphilis will progress to tertiary syphilis, where the bacteria will attack our internal organs and result in serious medical complications. So how is the diagnosis made? The doctors must first have a high index of suspicion, as symptoms of syphilis may mimic many other conditions. When someone who has a history of sexual exposure presents with primary or secondary syphilis symptoms, a venous blood sample is all we need to achieve a diagnosis. Fortunately, there are treatments for syphilis. For patients in the primary, secondary, and early latent syphilis, a single dose of benzathine penicillin injection is recommended. In patients who are in the late latent syphilis or syphilis of unknown duration, 3 doses of benzathine penicillin injection is recommended at weekly intervals. Alternatively, if the patient is allergic to penicillin, you can use antibiotics like doxycycline and tetracycline. Patients receiving syphilis treatment should abstain from sex until they are proven to be cured. They should also notify their sex partners so that they too can be tested and treated if necessary. Now, there is actually a significant link between syphilis and HIV. In the United States, 50% of men who have sex with men diagnosed with primary and secondary syphilis has HIV infection as well. Additionally, these men who are HIV negative and diagnosed with syphilis are at a higher likelihood to get HIV in the future. The reason is that the genital source in primary syphilis makes it easier for the HIV virus to be transmitted. Furthermore, syphilis and other STDs may indicate ongoing behaviors and exposure that may place the person at a greater risk of acquiring HIV. So please, to avoid getting syphilis or any other STD, please practice the below steps. Firstly, be in a long-term, mutually monogamous relationship. Use condoms correctly during sexual interaction. Thanks for staying till the end. Subscribe and like this video. We'll be sharing more about herpes infection in the next video. So till the next time, stay safe and stay healthy.